Okay, I'm back again. Let's get up here. I was told that these slide right out fairly easy once you put a little pressure on them. So I didn't order the puller. Well, I got a wig one. Haha. No, that's one. One injector I don't know if to test because it's broke. I guess I'd be making dairy frogs if I skipped garage, eh? The old tour. Oh.
Yeah, no. Busted.
This is the number one.
Oh.
That's number two.
Is it busted?
Well, had them pieces down inside of it, so.
Something's busted.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull them on. I gotta figure out what injectors are for the 3030. Turn her up 100 horse.
Do you have enough tools? I'm gonna go for the weld, I'll be back.
Yeah, I got enough. Thank you.
Bags with you? Towels?
No.
I thought I'd walk up here and grab a roll of towels. Fuck you, gonna be all fucking.
Oh, yeah, I do. Okay. I don't know if you can hear me way out here off to the side or what. Hopefully that's the last run for stuff. Should have enough now. I guess to explain about this, why I'm doing this, is I had a cylinder fill up with liquid. I will be, just shortly, testing the radiator, pressure tested. I don't think it's antifreeze. I had pressure in the system. So I'm thinking and hoping it's just an injector. Otherwise the head's got to come off, pull an injector cup out, replace the seals, and replace the head gasket. Well, that's a little more major and can't be done on site here. This is going to be a stretch getting this done outside. Like I said, this is something I've never done before. So please bear with me and have a little understanding that some of the things might take longer, and some of you that know what's going on are probably getting dummy. But this is the learning process. Choose to go down and share with you guys. I didn't look real close at that one. I do not know if you heard me or not, but the second injector, when I pulled the plunger out to run the injector, had metal pieces on it. So that was a good sign that my problems are all with injectors. Now, and I don't know if you heard my conversation with my friend or not, but this little L10 is only set at, I think 220 or 230 horse, or maybe 240, I don't know, I'd have to look down here on the build tag. But I'll have these injectors tested. If there's more than one bad, I'm going to be putting bigger injectors in. Let's see, I can't get my eyeballs on it. Yeah, 240 horse. So I like to crank her up a little more. Get her up over 300, get her in the 330, 340 range. Throw another horse out here. Hopefully. Now what it looks like to me is that second injector I took out has engravings on it. So has somebody been in here, or what's going on? Well, I'd say somebody's been in here, because I don't think Cummins put it together with a chewed up keeper like that. Someone didn't use a very good screwdriver by the looks of it when they were adjusting the rockers. A couple are chewed up pretty good. I'm gonna get rid of this because I got them all broke loose. Actually weren't even that tight. Okay, I gotta get a box ready here. So kind to start a box for me, but kind of. Get this back one apart, get that off. I'll show you the camera angle of the box of what I'm talking about. Most of you, I'm sure, see the video, already understand the box. I think I'll stuff some of these down just to keep stuff from going down the old injector holes and mop up some of my filthy mess up here. For some reason, I moved. Everything, and now I'm kind of lost. There's that one wants to come out. Thank you.